Hi friends, today we will see how to configure the shared store for this Apache ActiveMQ Optimus. So one of the difference between the other cluster and this cluster is like we need to share the paging directory, journal directory, large message and binding journal as mentioned in this document. So what happens is when in this configuration there will be a live server and backup server. So there is a shared file system that is between the live and backup server. So one of the advantage of this shared store is like we need to send the message only to the live server, and there is no need for backup server when the live server is up. So backup server will wait for this shared journal system, and then it will wait for the live server to be down. When the live server is down, backup server will take over the shared journal from messages. You get the messages from the shared journal file system, and then it will be functioning as like a live server. So, but when we want to share the file system between the live server and backup server, then we need to use the storage area network. The storage area network, it is a fastest network for the storage. We should not use NAS storage because it is an NFS file system. Like NFS file system, it is a NAS storage, right? We should not use that because it will be very slower than the NAS storage area network. Okay, so but for now I'm going to provide a configuration for the using the NFS storage only, because I'm going to send only few messages so that we will test it whether the message from the live server is taken over to the backup server. Okay, now we will go for the configuration. So in this configuration, I'm going to use Optimus create command. So here the options are the cluster, shared store, and these two configurations are same. And default port of these two server, live and backup server, is same. And an HTTP port will be different, and all other configurations are same, like user, password, host. I'm setting it as local host for now. If you are having in different machine the live and backup server, then you need to set the host, the IP address of the live server, and then the IP address of the backup server. Okay, now also we need to use the same username and password for the cluster user and the cluster password. Also anonymous user, if you want to log in, then we should not allow the making test no. And then for the slave, the configuration options will be -- slave. Master, there is no need to have configuration, and by default it will be the master only. This is how we need to configure. This is the command for the creating the master and the slave directory. So now I'm going to create the master and slave directory. So I'm going to extract it. No, I already extracted, so I'm going to delete that configuration. As I already downloaded this, I'm going to use the version 2.15.0. So here I'm going to command prompt. I'm going to execute this command for master. Also, I'm going to execute the command from slave. So here, if you look into the live and backup server, we have shared journal directory and large messages directory, paging directory, all those things. We need to share the both top directory itself. So data directory itself, we're going to share. Okay. Once the directory has been created, we need to configure one important configuration is we need to focus on. One is like here in this configuration, we need to use failover and shutdown just for the tutorial purpose, I'm going to add it as failover and shutdown, because I'm going to shut down the live server and then I'm going to make the backup server as live server. And also in backup server configuration, allow failback to true. I mean, it is allow failback to true, because when I'm going to shut down the backup server, or in case backup server is down because of some out of memory error like that, then live server will take over the backup server as a live server itself. Okay, the master is done. So I'm going into the master directory, etc directory. I'm going to the broker.xml. First we need to share the data directory. So I'm going to make it as like ./// /// So this should be configured for both live and backup server. So this is for master. I'm going to slave. I'm going to edit that one. And I'm going to share the data directory. /. You can also provide the complete path of the data directory, but here I am going to use /, because it is both the master and slave are in the same folder. So I am going to use etc data directory to be available in the Artemis home folder itself. So /// /. And one more thing is, your data is shared, and all the protocol, I'm making all the protocols available, because only one is available at a time. Here failover and shutdown is true, because I'm going to make the shutdown for the testing purpose sake. Okay, I'm going to remove the failover and shutdown, and I'm going to make the config allow failback to true. So that's it, configuration. So that's it. And after configuring it, I'm going to start the master server. And again, I'm going to start the slave server. I'm going to start the server now. So master server has got started. Now I am going to check whether this web pages of master server. I am going to log in into them using username and password. And here I am going to create a new queue. Okay, queue is available. Now I am going to put some messages into the queue. Some 4 messages available in the queue. Now I am going to browse and check whether the messages are available. There are 4 messages available in the queue. So now in backup server, I'm going to log in into the backup server, and then I'm going to stop the live server. Backup server has no messages are available till now. Okay. So another advantage of this shared store is the backup server will not be available, will not be taking any messages to be stored, because it is going to be shared by the messages directory, shared messages directory. If you see the configuration, in shared file journal, there is no connectivity between the live server and backup server for the messages. So when you put the message into the live server, backup server will not be containing any messages. Live server will store it into the shared storage, shared data directory. So when the live server is down, backup server will take up the messages from the shared file only, shared directory only, and not directly storing anywhere inside the backup server. But for all other clusters, live server and backup servers need to take the messages and store it somewhere inside the data directory. But for this, there is no need for overhead. There is no overhead for both sending the messages to the live server as well as in backup server. So this is the advantage. And after disadvantage is after some time, if the live server is down, the backup server will take some time to load the messages from the shared file system. Okay, so this is the one of the disadvantage, because it will be very slow if, depending upon the size of the messages and the number of messages. So now I'm going to stop the live server. I'm going to check whether now here, if you see that after the live server is down, backup messages are stored, and then it will be taken from the shared file system, and we'll check messages are available. All messages are available. Okay, so now backup server becomes live server, and if and after some time, I'm going to start the live server, because if it is down, and will become as a backup, because already there is one backup server that is live, so it is the live server become as backup now. Now if I stop the backup server, and the what happens is the live server will become active because of backup server is down, and we'll check the messages, all messages are available. See, we have all the messages available in the backup server, live server again. So that is the configuration for the shared store cluster. Okay, so for any information you need, that you can look into the description, and thanks for watching the video.